Dear friend, you are welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to practically show how to wire two different types of intermediate switches. Two different types in terms of their design. So we have one intermediate switch that comes with four terminals, and we have another one that comes with six terminals. And these two types are wired differently. And so in this video, I'm going to show how to wire the intermediate switch with four terminals, and then that with the six terminals. But before I begin, what is an intermediate switch and why is it important in electrical wiring? An intermediate switch is a special type of switch for three-way switching arrangement. Three-way switching is an arrangement that makes it possible for three different switches to control a lamp or a number of lamps. So in simple terms, you have three different switches positioned at three different points. And then each of these switches should be able to control this lamp. So here, I should be able to control this lamp from this switch. And then I should be able to control it from here. And then I should be able to control it from here. All right, so this is what is meant by three-way switching. And to be able to achieve this wiring arrangement, you would need two-way switches and then an intermediate switch. So this and these are two-way switches, and then the intermediate switch is at the middle. All right. The intermediate switch is normally sandwiched between two-way switches, and that is why it is called intermediate switch. All right. So when you want to control a lamp from three different points or from three different entrances, you would need an intermediate switch, and then you would also need two-way switches. Okay. First of all, I will show how to wire this type of intermediate switch. This type has four terminals, and as you can see, we have one here, one here, one here, and then one here. So the two terminals at the top are labeled L1 and then L1. And those at the bottom are labeled L2 and then L2. Then we need two-way switches together with this intermediate switch to be able to make this arrangement possible. The two-way switch has three terminals. So the terminals are labeled L, L1, and then L2. The other one is also a two-way switch. So the same labeling. You have L, L1, and then L2. All right, so we are going to use electrical wires to connect these terminals to be able to enable us to control this lamp from any of these switches. So normally this arrangement is used where you have three entrances and you want to conveniently control a particular lamp or a number of lamps from all those entrances. So now we have seen the terminal markings on the two-way switch. We have also seen the terminal markings on the intermediate switch. And so for simplicity, before I start the wiring, I would like to use a diagram to explain how the connection will be done. All right, so I'll be representing the terminals on the paper just as they look on the switch. So here, the first two-way has three terminals like this. And then the intermediate switch also has four terminals like this. And then the other two-way switch also has three terminals like this. And on the two-way switch, the terminals are labeled L1, L2, and then L. Okay, so L1, L2, and then L. On the intermediate switch, the top terminals are labeled L1, L1, L2, L2. Okay, so L1, L1 at the top, and then L2, L2 at the down. Then the last two-way switch is also labeled L1, L2, and then here is L. Then we have a lamp holder. The lamp holder also has two terminals, one and then two. Usually, most of the lamp holders come with three terminals. All right, so if the lamp holder comes with three terminals, the middle one is usually for earth connection. I'm going to use black for my neutral connections, red for my live connections, and then blue for the strap wires. So any live wire will be represented with red, any neutral wire will be represented with black, and then any strap wire will be represented with blue. So this is how the connection is going to be done. So first of all, we need a feed. All right, so this is two-way switch. This is intermediate, and then this is two-way switch. So this is two-way switch one, and then two-way switch two. Here, from circuit breaker, and we connect it to the terminal marked L. So this is normally referred to as feed. Then we connect L1 here to one of the L1 terminals in the intermediate switch. Then secondly, we connect from L2 here to the second L1 terminal of the intermediate switch. All right, then here also, we connect from this L2 terminal of the intermediate switch to L1 of the second two-way switch, like this. Then again, from the second L2 terminal to the L2 terminal of the second two-way switch, like this. This will be our switch wire to the lamp holder. So we take a connection from here to one terminal of the lamp holder. Then we take neutral from the second terminal of the lamp holder to the distribution board, like this. So this is neutral, this is live from distribution board, and these are referred to as strap wires or strappers. So we have two strappers here, and then we have two strappers here. This is a switch wire, this is neutral wire. So this is how the connection is going to be done to give us our three-way switching with this particular type of intermediate switch. Okay, so that's done. Let's start with the practical work now. So one two-way, intermediate, second two-way, lamp holder, and then lamp. So just as it was shown in the drawing, we connect the feed to this L terminal. In some switches, this L terminal is marked as COM, which stands for common. All right, so some switches will label this terminal as COM, that is COM, then L1, L2. So if you pick a two-way switch and instead of L, you see COM, is the same thing. It works as this L terminal. Okay, so just as it was shown in the drawing, we have our feed to this L terminal. All right, then from L1 here to L1 here. Then from L2 here to the second L1 here. Then from L2 here to L1 here. Then from the second L2 here to L2 here. Then from L here, this one will go to lamp holder. Okay, so this is how the lamp holder looks like. In this case, we have three terminals. This one and this one will connect to live and neutral. And then the one at the middle connects to earth. This is our switch wire. And switch wire connects to one of these terminals. And then the other terminal connects to neutral. This neutral is going to connect to the neutral bar at the consumer unit or the distribution board. All right, so full wiring completed. So we need to turn these switches over like this. So wiring done, all is set. And so with this arrangement, we can control this lamp from this switch here. We can switch it on here and then switch it off here. We can also switch it on here and then switch it off here. We can also switch it on here and then switch it off here. You can switch it on here and then switch it off here. You can switch it on from here and then switch it off from here. When it is off from here and you are entering from this entrance, you can switch it on. So this makes it possible for this lamp to be controlled from any of these switches. All right, so this is done. And then I want to quickly take you through the second one, which involves using this type of intermediate switch. This one is another type of intermediate switch that can be used together with two-way switches to provide three-way switching. So here, what I'm going to do is that I'll just remove this intermediate switch and then connect this one here. But in this second part, I will not talk much because I already have a video that gives detailed explanation of how to install this type of intermediate switch. That video is titled How to Wire Three Switches to Control One Lamp, and I have shared the link to that video under the description of this very video. Nevertheless, I will show you how the terminals are labeled, and then I will show you where each cable will connect to and then from. All right, so I have to remove this intermediate switch. All right, so though the terminals are many here, the connection is quite simple. If you look at the labeling, we have L1 here, then we have L11, and then L12. Here we have L2, L21, then L22. First of all, we look for two pieces of wires, and then we are going to bridge L21 with L12. Then we also bridge L11 with L22. All right, so L12 to L21, then L11 to L22. So here we are left with L1 and then L2 to be connected. So what we are going to do is that we are going to connect these two strappers to L1 and then L2. And then we connect these two strappers to L21 and then L22. So this one to L2 and then this one to L1. Then this one to L22 here. And then this one comes to L21 here together with this one. All right, so simple. And then we are good to go. So like this. Okay. So like this. And then we are done. Okay, so supply switched on. So just as we saw in the first arrangement, this switch should be able to control the lamp. This switch should also be able to control the lamp. And then this one should also be able to control the lamp. And then if I switch it on here, I should be able to switch it off from here. And I should be able to switch it on from here. Off, on, off, on, off, on. All right, so this is how to wire a three-way switching arrangement using these two different types of intermediate switches. That is the one with four terminals and the one with six terminals. All right, so what about four-way switching? What about five-way switching? What about six-way switching? And what about using 10 switches to control the same lamp or even more? Okay, so in my next video, I will practically show how you can use any number of switches to control one lamp or a certain number of lamps. That is to say, You can wire 4, 5, 6 switches to control one lamp. So please, if you have not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe so that you stay connected. Thank you very much for watching. Please, if this video has been useful to you, kindly click on the like button, share it to your friends, and share your comments at the comment section. And stay connected. See you in my next video.